buzzing and I was specific for my exams. But I assure you now that from now onwards there will be no delay in the videos. So we are back with the series, what is going to give the series of complex number. And before starting, if you have not seen the first three videos of complex number, please do watch them, because unless and until you watch those videos, you won't be able to understand this. Okay? And the link of those three videos are there in the description box. So put your bells and let's just start with the fresh topic of complex number, and that is Euler's form of representation. Okay? Euler's form. Okay. Fine. Now in the previous video we learned about how to represent any given complex number in polar form. Now we are going to continue how to represent, or we are going to learn how to represent any given complex number in any form, polar form or standard form, how to represent it in Euler's form. Euler's form basically says that the complex number should be written in the form of r e to the power I theta. Okay, where e to the power I theta represents cos theta plus I sine theta. Okay, fine. Now if this power becomes negative, this power becomes negative, e to the power minus I theta, then the value changes to cos theta minus I sine theta. Because we all know that cos theta, cos of minus theta gives us cos theta, and sine of minus theta gives us minus sine theta. Okay, this we all know, and if you don't know then please watch the video series of trigonometry. Okay, fine. Chal, let's move ahead. Here let's solve with the help of an example. Suppose we are having any value, say for example cos of pi by 3 plus sine of pi by 3. If you are asked to represent this in the form of this, in Euler's form, what will you do? Simply you are going to write it as e, because the value of r is 1 over here. So e to the power I theta, value of theta is pi by 3. Okay, simply your answer will be e to the power I pi by 3. Okay, answer. Fine. So this was your Euler's form of representation. After Euler's form, we have de Morgan's law. Okay, let's come to de Morgan's law. Okay, so Euler's form and De Morgan's law we have understood. Now, the most important topic of this chapter or of this video, not of this chapter, of this video, by the way, all were very important because we need to know all. But yes, now we are going to start with the cube root of unity, okay? Where we will learn about omega. Many of you might have heard about omega, but don't know what actually it is. So, fine. Cube root of unity. Cube root of unity. Okay? Now, what is this cube root of unity? How to understand this? If I give you any expression, say for example, x cube minus 1 is equals to 0. If this is the expression given to you, x cube minus 1 is equals to 0. Then very easily and very simply you can write, or leave it. If I give you x cube is equals to 1, then you can very simply put transpose it and write x cube minus 1 is equals to 0. And this you can write in the form x minus 1 into x square plus x plus 1, which will give you, let's just stick it here, 0. Okay? You can just see you are going to get the value. Okay. X minus 1 into x plus x square plus 1. X square plus x plus 1. Okay? Fine. Now, if you go back to your class 10 or to your class 9 quadratic equation, you all might have learned or you might have understood or you might have studied quadratic formulas. Here you can say now either x minus 1 equals to 0 or this equals to 0, whatever, that was the format of the quadratic equation. But you have learned the quadratic formula which says minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. This was the quadratic formula that you have learned. In class 9, so this was not there. In class 9, so the bach gaye the. But in class 10, I am damn sure you all might have studied this. Be it ICSE board or CBSE board. Okay? So minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. This was the formula that we have learned in class 10. Fine. Now, if I solve it by that form, I am going to get x is equals to minus 1 plus minus root 3 iota by 2. Okay? Now, if I split it into two forms, one answer I am going to get minus 1 plus root 3 iota by 2. And the other one I am going to get is minus 1 minus root 3 iota by 2. Okay? Now, if you just do the square of this number, this minus 1 plus root 3 iota plus 2. If you are going to get the do the square of this, you are going to get this. Okay? If you do the square of this, sorry, not this one, this negative. Because how to remember? Minus the square karenge to hum plus hi milne wala hai. Okay? So if you take one term as omega and the other term that you will get is omega square. This is the symbol for omega. Okay? So what you need to remember is, if you are taking a term as omega, other term you are going to get as omega square and the exact value. Okay? If you take the whole square of omega, you are going to get omega square. Fine? Chalo. Okay. Omega and omega square are just symbols. Where is the duster? Yeah. Now, we are going to start with the properties of omega. properties of omega. Fine. Okay. So the first and foremost property of omega is omega cube is equals to 1. Omega cube is equals to 1. Second property of omega is 1 plus omega square, and like this will give you 0. 1 plus omega square is gonna give you 0. Okay? ठीक है. अच्छा, if you remember, first या second video में हमने क्या पढ़ा था? Iota की property पढ़ी थी, which is same. Okay, addition and of multiplication. तो वो तो property क्या है? You are going to tell me in the comment section. Okay? चलो. Omega cube is equals to 1. 1 plus omega square equals to 0. Okay, let's come to third property. चलिए ये लिखते हैं. Third property of this is omega square whole square. Whole square of this omega square is gonna give you omega only. ठीक है? चल. Fourth property पे आते हैं. Fourth property क्या है? Omega square is equals to 1 by omega. ठीक? Omega square is equals to 1 by omega. These two properties are very important. Even this one. ठीक है? चलो, अभी तो सभी important है. इसको भी star बना ही लेते हैं. ठीक. Let's come to fifth one. चलो, fifth property क्या है? What is the fifth property? Omega is equals to omega square bar. Okay? Omega is equals to omega square bar. अब और भी प्रॉपर्टीज है, बट पहले एक सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी से हम एग्जाम्पल लेते हैं. लेट्स टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी. ओके फाइन. चलो लेट्स से फॉर एग्जाम्पल. अच्छा वेट, ये एग्जाम्पल ले ले या प्रॉपर्टी लिखने के बाद. चलो प्रॉपर्टी लिख लेते हैं पहले. ठीक है, अदरवाइज देयर विल बी नीदर ऑप्शन. पहले हम प्रॉपर्टीज लिख लेते हैं, नहीं तो पता चलेगा प्रॉपर्टी छूट गई तो देन मार्क्स विल ऑल्सो गो अगर उसको वेस्ट क्वेश्चन आए. ठीक है. Okay, fine. Now, the next property is omega and omega squared are the roots of z squared plus z plus 1 is equals to 0. Another property is z squared plus z plus 1 is equals to z minus omega z minus omega square. Okay, ये तो हमने अभी पढ़ा था जस्ट जब हमने क्वाड्रेटिक फॉर्मूला डिस्कस किया. और अगर कुछ भूल रहा है कि क्वाड्रेटिक फॉर्मूला ने कहाँ से डिस्कस किया तो ये देखो, स्किप जाओ पीछे और फिर वो देखो, सो यू विल अंडरस्टैंड. ठीक. एट इज 1, ओमेगा स्क्वेयर फॉर्म्स ज्योमेट्रिक प्रोग्रेशन जीपी. ठीक है. About GP, CBSE both students may not know because CBSE ने only arithmetic progression AP है class 10 पे, but in ICSE they have AP and GP both. So ठीक है, GP नहीं पता तो हम वो discuss करेंगे. Sequences and series chapter में है. Okay. Ninth property is if 1, omega square are vertices. If these are the vertices of an equilateral triangle with centroid, these are the vertices of a triangle with centroid 0, 0 and length, then the length equals to root 3. Length is equals to root 3. Okay? If 1 omega and omega square are the vertices of a triangle with centroid 0, 0, then the length of the side is root 3. चलो let's come to 10th property. Property तो बहुत है, बहुत नहीं पर फिर भी 10th property का दे 15 property. चलो, so let's come to 10th one. Minus omega and the square of minus omega are the roots of z square minus z plus 1 are the roots of z square minus z plus 1. 11 प्रॉपर्टीज, बिकॉज डिफरेंस क्या है, ओमेगा एंड ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर द रूट्स ऑफ जेड स्क्वायर प्लस जेड प्लस 1 इक्वल्स टू 0, बट माइनस ओमेगा एंड माइनस ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर द रूट्स ऑफ जेड स्क्वायर माइनस जेड प्लस 1 इक्वल्स टू 0, ओके, सो माइनस एंड प्लस साइन डिफरेंस इज देयर. कमिंग टू द 11th प्रॉपर्टी, जेड स्क्वायर माइनस जेड प्लस 1, जेड स्क्वायर माइनस जेड प्लस 1 इज इक्वल्स टू, जस्ट ये वाली प्रॉपर्टी रिपीट हो रही है, रिपीट नहीं हो रही बट केस यही है, माइनस एंड प्लस डिफरेंट साइंस. ओके, सो दिस इज इक्वल टू जेड स्क्वायर माइनस जेड प्लस 1 इज इक्वल टू जेड प्लस ओमेगा इंटू जेड प्लस ओमेगा स्क्वायर. ओके, 12th प्रॉपर्टी, 12th property, what does it say is z square minus 1 is equals to z minus 1 into z minus omega into z minus omega square. Theek, 13th property says z square plus 1 is equals to z plus 1 into z plus omega into z plus omega square. Okay, so this is the whole properties of omega. एक बार revise करते हैं. Omega cube gives you 1 plus omega square gives you 0. Omega square whole square gives you omega. Omega square equals to 1 by omega. Omega equals to omega square bar. Omega and omega square are the roots of z square plus z plus 1 is equals to 0. Z square plus z plus 1 equals to omega. Z minus omega into z minus omega square. 1 omega and omega square forms a GP. If 1 omega and omega square are the sides of or are the vertices of a triangle with center at 0, 0, then the length of the side is root 3. Minus omega and minus omega square are the roots of z square minus z plus 1 equals to 0. Z square minus z plus 1 is equals to z plus omega into z plus omega square. Z square minus 1 equals to z minus 1 into z minus omega square. Z square plus 1 equals to z plus 1 z plus omega into z plus omega square. So these were the properties of omega. We have completed the properties of omega and now you will be solving the questions of NCERT, NCERT exemplar. बहुत सारी बुक है, यहाँ से भी सॉल्व करना है सॉल्व करो. एंड इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम इन एनी ऑफ द क्वेश्चन, द कमेंट सेक्शन ऑफ यूट्यूब इज ओपन, इंस्टाग्राम इज ऑल्सो ओपन, इंस्टाग्राम आईडी आई एम अंडरस्कोर अनीशा पांडे. ओके, तो प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ओमेगा भी हो गया, सब कुछ हो गया, ओमेगा की क्यूब रूट यूनिटी डिस्कस कर लिया, ऑयलर्स फॉर्म, डी मॉर्गन्स लॉ ऑलमोस्ट कंप्लीटेड. So okay, till then we'll wait for the next video. I'll just go through it. अगर कुछ बचा होगा तो वो next video में cover करेंगे. Quadratic equation में भी थोड़ा सा part. And नहीं तो we will start with the next chapter, another chapter. ठीक है? I think permutation and combination. So permutation and combination बहुत interesting chapter है. It is very very interesting, super awesome chapter. So don't waste time. Just complete it because already हमारा time lapse हुआ है. So just solve it and till then keep studying, keep rocking, bye bye.